Hi everyone. Today I thought I'd share a column from the past. It's been a couple days, so this one is from May 1988 called Clean Fun. It's spring and farm people are busier than the bees on the dandelions in our backyard. Some farmers get so involved with planting they forget that other aspects of their life continue as usual. For them, everything comes in a distant second to getting those seeds in the ground. Yes, I know we're up against a weather-controlled timetable, and yes, I know a farmer who dawdles too long won't have to worry about what to do in October and November. I guess I'll never be a good farmer because I can't help searching for cracks in the work schedule. Those are the times when I get Bob to take a breather while enjoying the family we made together. Planting shouldn't be more important than hearing about your kindergartner's first lost tooth, or the game-winning home run at recess, or the 100% score on a math test. These milestones have to be honored, even during spring planting, for the good of the children as well as the farmer. We took a half hour off last night to enjoy each other's company in the backyard. To add to the smiles, I brought out a half-gallon bucket of homemade bubble soap. First, we dipped the usual plastic hoops and blew 2-inch bubbles. Then out came the super bubble maker. With it, we could create bubbles larger than a 5-year-old. Rachel's eyes were almost as big as the bubbles she watched float across our yard. Everyone had to take turns using the super bubble maker. A squabble broke out as usual. It's my turn. No, you popped my last bubble. It's my turn. Tell him, Mom. I'm happy when planting comes between me and this kind of dialogue. I was about to end the fight and the bubble fun when I remembered reading about blowing bubbles with one's hands. I stuck my hands in the foamy liquid, formed a circle with my fingers and blew. Bubbles large and small zoomed from my hand. Soon, the super bubble maker was forgotten. Everyone stood in the yard blowing into their hands. Soap bubbles dripped off elbows as our yard filled with delicate rainbow-dotted orbs. Children's laughter reverberated from the house to the barn. Soon, those sounds were joined with hearty adult laughter. Bob and I watched as our younger children commented on the shape and size of their creations, while Robbie couldn't blow anything worth mentioning from his hands. Cheap family entertainment, that's what our evening was. It won't ever make the 6 o'clock news, but somehow I know it has already become one of the memories I will cherish in my old age. I hope you don't let these little special family times pass you by because you're too busy. Remember, you only see reruns on TV. That's what I have for today, and I am so glad I wrote about this and definitely do remember blowing those bubbles out of the hands. And we did that numerous times, too. Little dish soap and water makes a lot of bubbles. I think it's a 10-to-1 ratio, and I feel like I'm kind of sliding with my words today because I broke a tooth and I won't get it fixed for a couple days. Oh, saw something outside. So he's going to take off on me. I hope you have a great day and enjoy the spring summer weather, because we're getting warm today in Wisconsin. Until next time.